Hi everyone, you're with Xolela Madlanga, and today I'm sitting down with the amazing Dr. Ngcakani-Ncula, and I'm talking to her about her journey in music. Dr. Pinky, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
I'm good. It's so good to have you again.
Yes.
I feel like our chats are always interesting.
Yes.
What I want to know from you is that people have always known you as a physician. And, you know, later on, we've known you through womb stewardship as an advocate, you know, for rebuilding communities. Mm. But now I want to know about your music journey. Where does that come from?
It comes back as far as I can remember. I think I was at the age of about 3 years when I found music to be a place of my comfort. I remember being abandoned by friends because I did not have the necessary ingredients for cooking, and I did not even have the pot for those outside play cooking sessions. So I started singing a song to myself. I actually composed a song, and it was like, comfort yourself with this song. Mm. So I used a small bottle to become a flask for my doll, and I used a small pot to become a pot for the play cooking. That is when I started singing and creating songs. Mm. My mother used to laugh at me when I started doing that, but it was literally when I was still very young.
Yeah.
Over the years, I would listen to my mother and father. They were in the Methodist church choir. And then at home, we would have that, the hymnal with the songs that were in the musical notes, and would sing from the hymnal, guided by the notes. And I started learning notes at that stage. I was also in the church, in the school choir. But I was never really somebody I thought could sing. Mm. At the age of 6, I was actually discouraged by a teacher in the Sunday school that my voice was horrible, that I should never even consider singing. And then I shut up until I started writing songs. Mm. So in 2006, I found the passion again. I started writing songs again, and I recorded them and I buried them away. Mm. So last year, I asked God to again sing for me, because that is the language I always find, you know, place of comfort, my place of refuge, music. So God asked me a very interesting question, which really stimulated and charged me. What are you going to do with the songs? Because every time I give you songs, you just bury them. You don't do anything with them.
Sure.
So I promised him, I said, God, if you give me songs this time, then I'm going to record them and I'm going to make them into an album. So from that time, that was now actually the birthing of the first CD of Womb Stewardship. There's something I'm forgetting to tell you, Xolela. When I got born again in 1998, the first thing that God said I must get rid of was all the secular albums that I had.
Wow. Okay.
And I had, if I was listening to Roberta Flack, for example, I would have everything of Roberta's, everything of Donny Hathaway's. And for me, music would take me from wherever I'm at to a point where I would hear, or where I first heard that song.
Yeah.
So if I was with boyfriend number one, and I would hear a song playing with him at that time, 10 years later, I would go back to that place because I had such a photographic memory. And for me, God was very instrumental in saying, get rid of all those memories from the past, because every song had a space, a place, and a face.
Amazing,
So to clear me, I think God had to, first of all, take away the music, because music talks to me in a very deep place.
That's really powerful. And the fact that, you know, you could recognize that and then take the steps in order to correct that, that's absolutely beautiful. As a person of womb stewardship, we recognize womb stewardship as a place that encourages people to pursue their talents, their abilities, and their capabilities. And here you are doing exactly the same thing. So what I want to know is, what drives you?
You hear everything about me being God, this, God, that. Because God really is the center. He is the source of my inspirations. I would like to say that he inspires, he really breathes into me, and he is the one who guides everything that I do. Salvation, for an example, that can only be God. I didn't get myself saved. He made me get saved. So my salvation, for me, it's living out the God in me.
Yeah.
It's living out the God in me. So God is multifaceted, and if we really are his image, then we should project the multifacetedness of God.
Definitely.
So if God says you're a physician, but beyond that, you are something else. Because I was not born a physician, I was born a human being, I was born the image of God. So over the years, layers and layers of who I am are coming out, and I believe that everybody who can allow themselves the opportunity to discover themselves in God and by God, I think if you can create an atmosphere or the ability to focus and zoom more into who we are according to God, we'll be able to unleash who we are.
Yeah.
Womb stewardship does that, because we are saying, get away from everything that's going to hinder and obstruct you from getting to find your strength, and channel all your energies and gifts to the best you can become.
That's absolutely stunning. Yes. Channeling your gifts to the best that you can become. That's absolutely amazing. Mm. And now, from a person who has a heart for worship, as a worshiper yourself, how would you define a worshiper?
Let me define worship first. Worship for me is really expressing our understanding of who God is. That's basically what it is. The expression of our understanding of who God is. It can be in any way. We can worship God by thanking Him. We can worship Him by giving to Him. We can worship Him by wanting to spend quality time with Him. Mm. So worship it's not anything that you do necessarily by bowing down or by leaning over or whatever. Yes, you can do that because that's how you revere a human, you revere a person of honor and of greatness. But it's beyond the body movements, it's beyond the songs we sing. It's a condition of the heart expressed out.
So important.
To be seen, yes. Yeah. So you can say, I worship God with your lips. But worship does not emanate from the lips. It doesn't emanate from the things that you're doing physically. It is a condition, a state of the heart. Mm. That is the heart of a worshiper. Then when you know how deeply intimate you connect with God, how great God really is, as far as you think or as far as you perceive, then that's what you do when you can express from the overflow of your respect and honor of who God is.
Absolutely beautiful. I love that. Mm. So now you are doing this beautiful thing for your event, and I'm truly excited to be there. For someone who doesn't know what's going to happen, what can they look forward to from the Womb Stewardship Ecclesia at Pentecost event?
Ecclesia at Pentecost.
Yes.
They're going to look forward to hearing, first of all, good musicians worshiping. We need to be, first of all, skillful. You can worship, I mean, whenever you worship, you don't need skill, but when you are listening to people who are really now anointed to worship, you're going to get that.
It's different.
But before we have the skill, for me, I want people who can really understand God so that they can express and pass that on to the people that are listening. So you must expect to be stretched first of all, because we really expect everyone to feel the presence of the Holy Spirit. That is the whole point about Ecclesia at Pentecost. The Holy Spirit must really be part of what we are doing. So we have two groups actually that are going to be ushering the presence of God for us that day. There's Resound and there's also Universal. Universal being the ones that have more songs that they've done for the city. They are going to lead us into worship. But every human being that is there has something in them that they can bring to the party.
Yeah.
To say, God, you are worthy. Because worship is about the worthiness of God, expressing the worship of God.
Yeah.
Yes.
Absolutely amazing. I'm truly excited to be there. Mm. And you heard it, guys. You're going to be stretched. You're going to be filled. And it's going to be a totally exciting experience. So you want to make sure that you get yourself there. So thank you so much again for taking your time to speak to me. Mm. It's always good. I'm truly excited. I mean, everything you put your hands on is going to turn to gold. So this is all we have for today. Please keep a lookout for more news. This is Xolela Madlanga.
Thank you very much. See you soon.
Jesus.